Hey guys! Today I wanted to come to you and talk to you about my Senegalese twists that I had done. Here they are right here. Here is the beautiful work. I am in Dallas, Texas, and I had them done by a lady named Aju, I believe her name was. I'll make sure that I include the contact information below. But she's located in Denton. I just basically wanted to come to you guys today and show you what my Senegalese twists look like. I love them. I typically try and get some kind of protective style done in my hair every year. So for this year, this is what I decided, the Senegalese twist, which I had the same exact thing done last year. But last year, I got them done by a lady, and I won't say her name, but if you look at my previous videos, you'll see, because I say her name in the video, and you'll see the Senegalese twist that I had done last year. They certainly are not as good as these here. So again, I just wanted to show you guys what they look like. They are braided super, super tight. They have loosened up because I've had them in my hair for about, it's been about 2.5, pushing 3 weeks now, which is really good because they don't look like it at all. But they are about, they come to like mid-back, kind of. So that's them right there. And again, they're beautiful. I absolutely love them. I haven't really found many styles that I can do with them yet, only because they're so heavy. I have this ponytail here, and I'm gonna actually like try to put them in a ponytail, and you'll see they're like super, super heavy. I think what I may have to do is just go and get those large ponytail holders for girls with long hair, which I'm not used to because my hair isn't super duper long. So these kind of ponytails work great for me, usually anyway, but with these braids, they just don't. But the braids are super thick and super long, and so the easiest thing for me to do in the morning while I'm getting dressed is to just put half of them up in a ponytail and wear the rest of them down. So as you can see, I really don't have to loop the ponytail holder twice, just because there's so many braids and they take up just that much of the ponytail. So, but if I show you, let me turn this way. I'll show you. See, it's like, it's so fat. But they're heavy though, guys. They're really heavy. So I don't even really like putting them in a ponytail holder because they pull on my hair up here. And I know you guys have heard of females that end up with alopecia around the hairline because they're either getting their hair braided too tight, they've been wearing braids for way too long, or when they do get braids, they pull them all the way back in a ponytail really tight until their hair ends up literally falling out around here. And alopecia is when the hair just simply doesn't grow back. I would much rather have it be a protective style, which is what it's, what I put the braids in my hair for, and just leave it as that, a protective style, something that's going to protect my hair, something that's going to keep it healthy in the meantime, and something that requires very, very minimal maintenance and upkeep, which is the Senegalese twists. They again require very minimal maintenance and upkeep, which is a really great thing. So again, here they are right here. One of the things that I found myself doing, I've washed my braids twice already, and for them to look this good after having washed them twice is really, really good. But I found a new method, guys. So basically, in order to grease my scalp every day, instead of me taking grease and putting it on the palms of my fingers, what I do is I have this Carol's Daughter Manoy bottle, and it has a spout on it. And you see there's nothing in there because I've used it up, basically. So let me show you the spout. What I did, see that, was I took castor oil and olive oil, put it on the inside of the bottle, and so basically whenever I want to grease my scalp, I just put it wherever I need it. So like, let's put it right there, and then I just pump, you know, like wherever I need to put the castor oil or whatnot, I just give it pumps, and then I just kind of blended into the rest of my scalp. Oh, this has worked wonders for me doing it this way. The other thing that I wanted to tell you guys is washing the braids has been extremely easy for me this time around because I found a new method, a new way to do it. And let me show you guys what that is. Okay, so I'm just going to use this, right? And I'm just going to pretend to do this. This is a new washcloth. It's my husband's washcloth, so I don't want to get it all dirty. But anyway, I put water and I lather it up with shampoo on the towel. And just to wash just this part, the braids part, I'll just put it on my braids and then take it down and do this. And just kind of pat it. And then I know that I have to get like a lot of the greasy residue and stuff off of the top part of my braids. The middle is mainly hidden throughout the week, but the top part is where, you know, it's exposed to a lot of dirt, dander, oil, stuff like that. So the top part is where I try and focus. And again, I'll, you know, just take the washcloth and pat it with shampoo and water lathered on it. And then once I'm done, I'll make sure that I take the washcloth and literally go down on my braids like that while the washcloth is still soaking wet. And that's again just to get the rest of the residue off. And so I use this routine and I do the same exact thing for my conditioner. Once I'm done with all of that, then I'll take the washcloth real good, lather it, I mean not lather it up, but just soak it in warm water. And I use the same exact method just to get the shampoo and the conditioner out of my hair. And then as far as washing my scalp, I use a spray bottle. And I just basically take the spray bottle, get it all between my braids, all over my entire head with the spray bottle. But inside of the spray bottle, what I use is I use shampoo. And generally, I put an oil in there, like a olive oil, just because olive oil seems to be the most healthiest for your hair. So I put that in there. I'll let the shampoo sit on my scalp for a little bit after I've sprayed my entire scalp with the spray bottle. Then afterward, I rinse it with the spray bottle. Another way that you can do it is, you know, you can use the sprayer on your kitchen sink if you have one. You know, you spray vegetables and stuff with it. You can use that. And so just basically take that, try not to put it on your scalp because it is used for like food purposes, but anyway, take that, put that near your scalp, spray down your scalp just to get the shampoo and everything out of it, and then use the same method when you get ready to do your conditioner. And you can give yourself a hot oil treatment with the braids as well. For me, I use basically the same exact thing that I showed you guys in the beginning. This is my daily maintenance bottle here. So if I want to do a hot oil treatment while I have my braids in my hair, I'll put this in there. I'll heat up the oil first, put the oil and stuff in here, put it all on my scalp, let it sit for a while, or put a heating cap on my hair, pull up the braids, put a bonnet or heating cap or something on there, let it sit for a while, and then afterward, just gently rinse my hair out along with my scalp with the sprayer from the kitchen sink and just let it go like that. So there is a easy and a healthy way to keep your braids up while you have them in. You don't have to worry about going for a long time without giving yourself a deep conditioning treatment or a hot oil treatment, or you don't have to worry about your scalp getting all flaky and dry while you have the braids in, because that is something that I experienced in the past and I just literally didn't know how to take care of my scalp and I didn't know what to do. So I would take my braids out like every month and a half to 2 months later, just because my scalp just couldn't take it anymore. My hair needed to be washed, and as you know, us females, we pay so much to have braids put in our hair, $200, $250, you know, up to $300 just to have braids put in our hair. A lot of us don't want to take the braids out within a month to a month and a half or even to 2 months. So for me anyway, if I can prolong it a little bit by way of keeping my hair still, you know, as healthy as possible, then I will. Now, if it gets to a point in which there's no way in the world that my hair is healthy and I can't keep it healthy while I have the braids in, then guess what? I'm taking the braids out, simply because the braids is a protective style to protect my hair from the elements and to keep it healthy. So if it's not keeping it healthy, then what's the point in keeping the brands in my hair? So again, I just again wanted to show you guys what my Senegalese twists look like. I'll take them down again for you and give you a little side view of what they're looking like. And again, I'm telling you guys, I absolutely love these things. They're so easy. The only thing that I don't like is that they're heavy, but they're so easy to maintain. And they're so pretty, and I really do feel like I'll have these in my hair for a while. So, there it is, guys. These are my Senegalese twists, and hopefully once these babies loosen up a little bit more, or if I feel like it, then I'll come to you guys and show you some cute hairstyles that you can do with them. So until then, bye!